一瞬间警报声大响，芝加哥立刻被强烈的风暴笼罩。恶劣的天候状况不止打乱民众的生活，也是航空公司最头痛的情况。
The challenging days are those thunderstorms, those pop-up summer thunderstorms and severe weather season, which is between April and September, where we have the bulk of the nation traveling, and that's when we have the most inclement weather.
光是佛州四月份的大雷雨就造成9000架航班延后，3000架班次取消。好不容易挥别疫情阴霾，机场里到处都是拖着行李的旅客，准备好好享受长途假期。但夏季风暴却可能让他们败兴而归。航空公司也得承受庞大的损失。
We saw last summer in 2021, Spirit Airlines losing about $50 million in revenue because of a spate of delays and cancellations. Southwest, a few months later, had one that costed about $75 million.
2019年，美国因为航班延误造成航空公司$83亿的亏损，乘客的经济损失更是达到180亿。航班延误或是取消，超过半数都是因为坏天气。美国联邦航空总署有专门的机构因应，旗下的空中交通管制系统指挥中心负责全美航空的调度，掌控全球70%的飞航，扛起维持班机准时抵达的重责大任。
Weather plays a huge factor to any traffic management initiatives that we're implementing. Today is a Texas day, so we have thunderstorms ranging in Texas market and up into the Memphis market as well.
指挥中心里有一群经验老道的气象专家，成为调整飞航计划最重要的咨询顾问。
All right, good morning, everyone. Looking at the map this morning, we have a cold front off the east coast, a few storms out there.
虽然各大航空公司还有机场也有气象专家提供意见，但指挥中心的气象学家可以整合讯息，为当天的气候状况拟定出更全面性的应对措施。
So if you've got thunderstorms that have their tops around, say, 37 or 38,000 feet,You know, that's at the level that your commercial airliners are flying. So you don't want to fly through those. You've got to be able to fly around them safely. You see, right now, a lot of these airplanes are moving in and trying to get in through these thunderstorm gaps and get into Fort Worth.
美国一年平均有100,000场的暴风雨，光是去年就有高达939次的地面停飞令。不只是影响乘客的行程，也冲击到航空公司后续的设备还有人力调度。除了靠指挥中心调整路线，美国航空也采用一款效率分析系统，号称能让航班取消的状况减少80%。
It looks at our aircraft routings. It looks at where the aircraft are coming from. It looks at our crew limitations. It takes into consideration our customers. We have large connecting groups on flights coming in, and we take all this and model it around what we believe the limitations are going to be imposed from the weather. And we can use this tool to allow ourselves to delay.Through the operation, allow ourselves not to cancel.
虽然有了分析系统，但天有不测风云，尤其夏季的天候状况格外不稳定，就怕太多次的航班调整影响到品牌形象。就算今年夏天飞航需求量暴增，业者还是不敢增加航班数量。
We're going to keep essentially our current level of operations intact throughout the summer. We're not going to grow at all.Because the reliability of the product that we're providing the customer is more important than again chasing that last dollar of revenue.
捷兰还有达美航空都因为人力还有天候考量，今年夏天甚至选择减少航班。未来受到全球暖化影响，极端气候越来越频繁，航空业者还得面对更多的考验。TVBS 新闻综合报道，
掌握全球情势，国际新闻全新选择 YT 频道 TVBS 国际 Plus 扩大视野，欢迎订阅并开启。小铃铛。